project I did was Ceasar Salads. I don't know how many beats was on there, but it was just like a spirit moment thing I had. Like some spirit beats laying around. It's kind of, I won't call them throwaways, but they was kind of like throwaways, except for a few of them. Most of them I kind of was just like, you know what, I'm gonna just sit down and whatever I make, I'm just gonna make it specifically for this project. And whatever I come up with is what I come up with. And I put it out, and the response I got was real great. Put it on one site, and 11 other sites picked it up. And a lot of people have asked it for more. So that's what I'm doing, and making it, this one a little more rhymer friendly. The other one was more from a production standpoint, just me doing little tricks and all that kind of stuff, just showing out with NPCs and SPs and ASIs. And so that was just what that was. Now this one is going to be more geared towards song friendly, like you can actually do songs and stuff too. That's what this will be about here. And I actually wanted to do a whole complete project down in a new spot, so I figured why not make that the next project to do. So that's what I've been working on. As far as like the sound of it, I want everything to be like really big, drums really big, and snares snapping, and I just kind of want to take my time with the mix process of it, of just making it sound like I feel it should sound. You try not to make everything so similar to, because it has like a different feel to it. Just as far as like the samples and stuff I used on it is just things that I like, no particular genre, and it just sounded good to me, I used it. And I did, you know, some stuff is real simple, some is a little more complex, some is chopped, some is straight loops. So that's just how I did that. Many of my cousin let me borrow his EPS, man. I had it like 2 days, he came right back and got it from me. It was like 88, 89. I couldn't figure out how to do nothing on it. He just gave it to me, like, here, cuz, use it. And, like, I did not do, like, one thing on it. I found out years later that it was an EPS. It's on an EPS. So that's kind of like what I learned on EPS. EPS 16 Plus is actually what I learned on. And then from there, I got an EPS. And then from there, I bought, like, I've had all kinds of stuff, man. I've had, oh, my God, as far as, like, machines, EPS, SP1200, MPC 60, MPC 1000, MPC 4000, MPC 3000, 2000, 2000XL, ASR10, yeah. As far as my favorites go, man, I think my favorite was probably the MPC 3000, MPC 2000XL. They were like the only ones I didn't sell or trade. Or, you know, those are my toys, my favorite toys, man. As far as like the records go, I'm a record addict, man. I think that's like my thing, man, when we go out of town, man. I don't really buy a lot of clothes and stuff like I used to. I'm more into like where the record shops at, where cool spots to be at. And I'm looking for stuff that I've never seen or know about. I don't like to listen to records when I'm shopping for records, if that makes any sense. I love the mystery of trying to find out, because every record, man, will tell you, like, if you just grab a record, it'll pretty much tell you about itself. You know, that's what a lot of people did back in the day. That's actually how I record shop. But, you know, I go to the different genres that I'm looking for, and I look for the names of the players, and I can actually hear a whole record without ever having to listen to it, because the people back in the day, they love to brag and show you how bad they is. You know what I'm saying? Cats love to be like, oh, I played this on there, that on there, that on there, this on there, that on there. They like to show off. So this is, like I tell you, lead guitar, rhythm guitar, electric piano, minimal. Like, they literally break it down, like clavinet, acoustic piano, bass, drums, percussions. So they just, you know, tell you how it sound, really. So that's how my record shot, man. I look and see for the players, look and see who's on it. I mean, some cats, if I really, really like them, I'll just buy it on GP. And then, yeah, I bought albums just strictly because of the album cover. Like, it was just a dope album cover, so I bought it, you know, because it looked dope. I also look at, like, the years. I'm really a big fan of, like, early 70s. I love the cars from that era, the music from that era. Just everything was kind of good. Like, out of the civil rights movement, people were, like, a little happier and more love-free, and you have different people experimenting with music and stuff like that. So almost every genre from that era is dope to me. I don't really buy orchestra records, symphony records, country records. So everything you see behind me is like something that I like, that I'll listen to. It ain't about just like sampling. And that's pretty much how I get down. I just take what I heard and incorporate it into what I'm doing and just stuff that inspired me. Sometimes I don't even wanna come down here and make no music, and I won't. I'll just come down here and listen to records, and sometimes I just create stuff on the spot. Rarely is it because I was forced to do it. You know, I just love doing it, and that's, to me, what makes the best music, and hopefully you'll hear that in this Ceasar Salad 2 project.